This video will introduce you to coding queries in NVivo. Before we begin looking at the query, however, let's revisit codes. Whenever we double-click on a code, NVivo runs a very basic coding query to show us all of the content coded to that code. Here I've double-clicked on Policy Management and it's showing me all of the text to this code. Similarly, if I double-click on Infrastructure, the same basic coding query is run and NVivo will show me all references to this code. As you've seen in previous videos, these references can be textual, video, data, image, or any other file type supported by NVivo. And we can browse the coding by clicking on the tabs to the far right-hand side. Here, I'm looking at the coding references that are textual, here the coding references that are visual, videos, and finally the coding references that are datasets. The coding query enables us to go into greater depth than these simple double clicks on a code can do. To start a coding query, first go to the Explore ribbon, and then select the Queries button, and then choose Coding. The coding query criteria will open in Detail view. Let's build one of these queries. I'm going to rearrange my interface to make some more room. You'll see this is based on logic, so at the top all of the following must be true. The next row allows me to select either coded or not coded to, and I'm going to leave this at the default of coded to. I then have an option of selecting all of the selected codes and cases, any of the selected codes or cases, or any case where. In this case, I'm going to select all selected codes or cases, and then choose the dot 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 button to go in here and select the code. Since we've just looked at infrastructure, I'm going to select this and click OK. Now if I run the query at this point, it will give me the exact same result as double clicking on the infrastructure code, but you'll see there are many more options available in here. Let's start off by adding a new row of logic. I click on the plus button. This now adds another row with the exact same options as the row above. I'm going to leave this at coded to, but this time I'm going to change all selected codes or cases to any case where. I'm then going to click the dot 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 button, choose the person case classification, and then select gender and choose OK. I then have the option to leave this at equals value and choose either male or female, the two attribute values. I'm going to leave this at female. Now when I run the query, it's going to find everything coded to infrastructure, but only for cases where the person's gender equals the value of female. You'll see the number of results here have reduced, but this is a much more precise query, showing me the results from both the survey responses and the interviews. I can go on to add further logic. For example, I could go in and select any case where, and this time add the person recreational fishing attribute, and then choose the attribute value yes or no. If I select yes and rerun my query, this will now only find content coded to infrastructure, where the case classification person gender equals the value female, and the person case classification attribute recreational fishing equals the value yes. You'll see now my results have reduced down to just Barbara and a couple of the survey responses down here. I can then go back and select no and rerun the query to relook at these results, but only where the recreational fishing attribute was no. I can then explore the views of the men by selecting male instead of female. This is a much more detailed way of exploring your coding. The next video in this series will again revisit this coding query to look at how you would use it when using sentiment coding.